Hey, you! I need you to hit that subscribe button. Subscribe.
What's up, man? What's your name, bro?
Tyrone.
Tyrone, my name is Yosef. Tyrone, are you content with your people living in the projects? So what's the solution, Tyrone? How do we get out of the projects? You're right, Zephaniah 2. Right, Zephaniah 2. We have to come together, right, as a people. But under what? Because let's say I believe that men can be homosexual. But you don't believe that men can be homosexuals, Tyrone. How can we agree together? Hold Zephaniah 2, give me Amos 3.
I don't know that one.
Right, let's say I have daughter. I have a daughter, and I have, I have daughters and sons, right? As do brothers around me. We have children. Let's say a person believes that he can sleep with my young daughter. That pedophilia is good. Can we come together?
Can you help me?
Yeah. No, why not?
Because he believes
something that I don't believe.
Yeah.
So if we're going to gather together as a people, we all must unify under something that we all can universally say is right.
But what he doing,
right?
What we doing is, I feel like it's destruction.
It is. It is. We're going to show it though. Read what you got. Yep. The book of Amos, chapter 3, verse 3. Can two walk together except they be agreed? The Bible says, can two people walk together except they agree on the same thing? The answer is no. I can't gather with a person that believes in pedophilia. Yeah. I can't gather with a person that believes in homosexuality, because right, both of those things are destructive to my community, Tyrone. Both of those things are anti-life, not pro-life. Now, Zephaniah 2. So you said something. We got to come together. The Bible says that. But what people don't come together, Tyrone? Us. The only time we come together, Tyrone, is for stuff like this. Standing out here, drinking, smoking, selling dope. If a woman walked through with a fat behind, we all sit up there and gather together. God damn, you see? That's what we do. Yeah. We gather for much evil. The Bible calls us wise to do evil. A woman can live 2 hours up the road. I don't have a car. I don't have money. But guess what I'm going to figure out? I'm going to figure out how to get this money and get this car to drive my ass 2 hours up the road to get some ass. Yeah. That's wise to do evil.
Nice.
But to do good, we have no knowledge, no wisdom, Tyrone.
Right.
Read. Zephaniah chapter 2, verse 1.
Read.
Gather yourselves together.
Read.
Yea, gather together, O nation, not desire. The Bible tells us to gather together, nation, not desire. Look at where you live, Tyrone. Does this look like a place where you store people that society desires?
No.
This looks like we are outcast.
Right.
Around the corner, there's a Planned Parenthood, Tyrone. Why don't they have Planned Parenthoods in white communities?
Teach.
What?
Why don't they have, you know what Planned Parenthood is, right?
Planned Parenthood.
Planned Parenthood. Planned Parenthood is an abortion clinic.
Oh.
Around the corner from the projects where nothing but black and Hispanic people live is a place where a black woman can go and kill her baby.
That's right.
In her community. Why don't you see Planned Parenthoods and abortion clinics in white women's communities?
That's right.
They fund out people. They want them to...
Go ahead.
They want them to grow. But
they want them to populate.
Right. They try to stagnate us.
That's
exactly
right.
Exactly. And you know how we help perpetuate that? By whoring out our sisters, sleeping with them, not raising our children with them, to where now they believe my only option is to go and kill this baby because these niggas ain't going to help me raise them.
Right.
We got to do better, Tyrone. We got to do better. Give me that. How do we gather together? Because we gather together under something that we know is universally right. Is marriage an evil thing? It's become evil. Why? Because most people marry for the ring, for the big fat rock, and for the glorious wedding. They don't get married because they want to build a nation together. They don't get married because they want to build inheritance together, raise children together, grow old together. They get married because they want people to see them on Facebook and Instagram. They get married because they want to show off their fat rock to their homegirls, to piss their homegirls off who don't have a husband. It's all about politics now. It's all about being seen now. It's not for righteousness.
Yep. It ain't real no more.
Cause it's not real no more. That till death do us part thing don't exist. It's till I find something better, or till you piss me off enough and then I leave.
You know how I see
read what you got.
That situation right now, pardon me. I feel like we caught up in a different time zone where the real people look fake to people.
Right.
And they're fake.
You're right.
Look real.
Real. Fake has become the new real. Fake has become the new real. Niggas walking around talking about Molly and Percocet and drugs don't do drugs. Yeah. But they understand they can push that to you and you do it, but they'll make money off it. Right? They sell a dream. For example, they push all over the TV and in the black community promiscuity. They push homosexuality, they push hit the club, get some cheeks, or do you, go get some dude, but you a boss. But none of it's about marriage. And then on the TV they plaster single mothers and raising single babies. But in white families, it's a man, it's a woman, it's children. Yeah, but watch what the Bible says. Read.
Hebrews chapter 13, verse 4. Read. Marriage is honorable in all.
The Bible says marriage is honorable in all. How many men should one woman be with in her life? One man. Right. Why? Because that man's supposed to be her husband. Marriage is honorable. By the time a woman, the average woman running around here, how many men they done laid with? You can't even count. And she probably not gonna tell you the truth of it. Why? Because it's embarrassing. It's shameful.
Right.
It's shameful. It's not honorable. It's nothing honorable about our sisters running around here sleeping with every man they can. Because by the time they do want to get married, they use the goods. And don't nobody want to marry them.
Teach.
No one wants to marry that. Would you want your son to marry that? Would you want your daughter to marry a man that's running around sleeping with every woman? You wouldn't. Read it again.
Marriage is honorable in all.
The Bible says marriage is honorable in all. Marriage is honorable. There's a righteous way to fix your communities. One way is for men to marry these sisters. Stop hoeing these sisters out.
Right.
The prophets of the Lord are coming back in earth. And every time we send one of our sisters into that building to kill one, you stop the prophet from coming to redeem you out of your captivity. We gotta do better, man. You had something to say, man?
About the marriage. I've been through that. I'm a widow, right?
You a widow?
Widow.
I'm sorry to hear that, man.
All right. Like, 2016, I'm done the
homicide. Wow, I'm sorry to hear that, bro. The dude she was messing with? So she was committing adultery.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, read that again. I'm sorry to hear that. That doesn't sound good, but that's this coming to pass. His wife, while he was locked up, committed adultery on him, and the dude she was messing with killed her. Read it again.
Marriage is honorable in all, and the bed undefiled, but whoremongers and adulterers God will judge.
Now, give me that in Leviticus 20. Now, that's biblical. God says that he will judge adulterers and adulteresses, right? How does God judge them, right? Because back in the day, during the time of Moses, there was a law that stipulated, well, we're going to read it. We're going to read it for you. Because she got put to death. She got put to death. Why? Because she was breaking the law of God.
Right.
Read what you got.
Leviticus chapter 20, verse 10.
You said this was your wife, right? So that will make her an adulteress in God's eyes, read.
And the man that committeth adultery with another man's wife, even he that committeth adultery with his neighbor's wife, the adulterer,
the man,
and the adulteress,
and the woman,
shall surely be put to death.
Shall what?
Shall surely be put to death.
So God judged her for that because you were her husband and she's your wife. So God says they shall surely be put to death that commit adultery. That's what the Bible says, right? So we got to do better, right? Read that one more time. What's your name, bro? What's your name, man?
Tyree.
Tyree and Tyrone. Y'all make that easy for me, man. Tyree and Tyrone, right? Tyree, that's your brother? Okay, okay. You know you're an Israelite? You know you're an Israelite according to the Bible? All praise. We're about to find out who we are according to the Bible. It's Black History Month. So we might as well learn some black history, right? Give me that in Deuteronomy 7 and 6. We're going to start there. Because do you think, let me say it like this. Are all people equal? Everyone's equal? No, everyone's not equal. Am I equal with Joe Biden? Am I equal with Oprah?
No. No, I'm not. All people, we know that common sense wise, right? Yeah. So why do we suffer people to tell us this fictional idea that everybody is the same? When we can look around and see that everybody doesn't live in the projects. Yeah. You know, everybody doesn't have baby killing clinics
everybody
in there.
Everybody isn't rich.
Everybody ain't rich.
Yeah.
You know, everybody doesn't live long lives.
Everybody don't have food.
Right, exactly. So we are, so clearly we all not equal, right? Read what you got. I'm gonna show you the Bible says that we all ain't equal. But things are out of order. Read. No problem, no problem, man. Before you go, listen to this real quick. Deuteronomy chapter 7, verse 6. For thou art an holy people unto the Lord thy God. The Lord thy God have chosen thee. And the Israelites, you, me, and our people, though we don't look like it right now. Read. To be a special people unto himself, above all people that are upon the face of the earth. So God said that the Israelites were supposed to be above everybody, not equal to. We fighting to be equal with people, but they fighting to be better than us.
Right.
But we, the same people that tell us to be equal, are telling their children to be better.
Nobody is fighting to be equal.
No, no, no. We're fighting to be equal with them. They know that they're above us.
We are the
sons of God. We are, but we gotta act like it. We gotta act like it. Hey, come on.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission. Minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.